No matter how strong or fast you are, if you went up against the rest of the animal kingdom in most challenges, you wouldn't do that well. Take Usain Bolt, the fastest we've got. In his record-setting 100-meter dash, he was moving almost 28 miles per hour. But that's nothing compared to the top speed of a cheetah, or a horse, or an ostrich, or even a lot of house cats. Take almost any contest, and humanity wouldn't stand a chance. But there is one event where Homo sapiens might possibly beat everybody else. Running marathons. We have the endurance to run really far, 10, 20, 30 miles. Ultramarathoners run 100 miles in a go. We might be the best endurance runners on the planet. And I really like this idea, partly because before I was a scrawny, out-of-shape adult, I was a scrawny, in-shape kid. I was really short, and I wasn't that fast, but I could run for a long time. So when I heard about an event in Wales where humans actually race against horses, I decided I had to go see it.
So I packed my lunch, and I gave my boss the slip. Wrote myself this theme song, going on a field trip, yeah.
Miles, left on A483, then arrive at
Llanwrtyd
Wells on right.
Arriving
at
Llanwrtyd
Wells on right.
Llanwrtyd Wells.
So how do you say the name of this town?
Llanwrtyd Wells.
What? Llanwrtyd Wells.
Llanwrtyd
Wells.
Llanwrtyd Wells.
Llanwrtyd
Wells. Llanwrtyd Wells is the smallest town in Britain, with just 600 people, and lots of sheep. But today, its population is about to double because for the 36th year in a row, the town is hosting a human versus horse marathon. And it all started at this hotel.
I was in the bar one night with a local huntsman, and I said that a runner would be much faster than a horse over a long distance. We decided that we'd put it to the test, and that's how it all started.
Now, over the past 35 years, a horse has usually been the champion.
Any advice for the newcomers? It's great advice.
But every so often, a human wins. The first person to do it was actually a man named Hugh. How did Hugh manage it? It turns out our bodies are actually built for long distance running. We've got structures in our inner ears to keep us balanced with all that jostling, springier tendons than our primate cousins, so we bounce as we run and use less energy, a narrow waist and huge bottom muscles that keep our trunks stabilized. So as the competitors gather, there's a question in the air. Who will win this year? Humans? Or the animals they've bred for centuries to be fast and strong? To avoid getting trampled, the humans start first. Then, 15 minutes later, the clock starts for the horses. It's 22 miles of mud, mountains, and river crossings. In addition to their springy tendons and big bottoms, these humans have a few more things going for them. They don't have to carry a person. They're nimble on turns and steep inclines. And if it was a hot day, they'd be better at keeping cool. This last ability is a really big part of what made our ancestors such great long-distance runners. Take your great-great-great-great-great-great hundreds of thousands of times great-grandpa. He descended from the trees, lost his fur, and is moving around on two legs. And all that evolving has made him hungry. He doesn't have spears or arrows yet, and he can't run faster than this antelope. But he can sweat. And the antelope can't. It needs to stop and pant to cool down. So on a hot day, if your ancestor just keeps chasing that antelope, it can't stop, it can't cool down, and eventually it will collapse from heat exhaustion, and your ancient ancestor will get to have dinner. Today's a bit different. These humans aren't chasing a meal. And horses, unlike antelopes, actually can sweat. They just don't cool themselves as efficiently as humans do. But none of that matters today because a cooling rain is falling. So it's anyone's guess who's going to win. Could be a human, could be a horse. The first finisher coming in at 2 hours and 30 minutes is a human. In fact, it's another man named Hugh. But remember, he had a 15-minute head start. And just a few minutes later, the first horse comes in. It's time, 2 hours and 20 minutes. A horse is this year's champion. But the humans held their own. And Hugh did beat 46 of the 50 horses.
I might make that a sort of tagline.
Yeah. Put it like the bumper sticker, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Faster than 46 out of 50 horses.
That means if he'd lived a million years ago, he would have been able to have meat for dinner. And that's what makes the human ability to run long distances such a big deal.
The theory goes that running got us meat, and meat fueled our evolution. All that fat and protein helped build bigger brains. It gave us time to invent tools, domesticate animals, create language, culture, science, music. In short, running made us who we are.